Hello guys, KP Shamino here with a new video for Fishing Planet, and as promised yesterday in my patch video, I'm going to show you guys the four spots and what you need to use on those spots to get the four biggest fish here. So for the guys that come here for the first time, you got four species that are the biggest. That is Shane Pickerel, the Northern Pike, you got the Walleye, and you got the Sauger. So that are the four that I'm going to show you guys in this video. So what I'm going to do is first, for the guys that just want hardcore tutorial, I just going to show you guys that are the positions, that are the coordinates, that's where you need to stand, that's what you need to use, and you guys can start right away. So you can just go to that spot row and you are going to catch it. So, and then after I did that, I'm going to catch the fish on the spots with my kayak. So that's a little bit more gameplay. The Northern Pike is going to be hard, I think, because it's not easy to get him. But of course, I'm going to show you guys where you need to get him. So let's get going. I'm going to use the new navigation system because it's very good. It's very easy now to make tutorials. So you just got the buoy and that's where you need to be. So let's have a look. So I marked all the positions of the four big fish on my screen here. So we're going to start with the chain pickerel. So the chain pickerel is sitting in this area. So that's where I throw it, just behind the lily pads, but you guys will see it. It's 26.68. So for the hardcore tutorial guys, if I click on it, you guys can see it, casting spoon 14G20, works really well. Just do a stop and go or a lift and a drop and you will be okay. Where do you need to sit with your kayak, or where do you need to stand? If you stand on the shore, you stand here. If you sit in your kayak, you stand here. Okay, so you throw like this and then you go back. Because if you stand here, you are not going to catch them because they are sitting over here. Okay, the next mark is the walleye. So here you can see the walleye. The best to get a walleye is at night. They bite insanely at night. I'm using the 7G1, a G-head, and a shed 7 cm, the night one. So it's here at the edge of the deep spot, the fall-off position here. So where do you need to stand? You can stand here on the shore and throw like this, or you stand here with your kayak and you throw like that. Okay, that's the position. I need to say the coordinates, 29 minus 51. So you guys can see it here. Then the sauger is over here. I fish on the sauger at night too. I think that the unique is at night too. So yeah, here you can see it. What do I use for it? The narrow spoon, 21G30 hook. And it's once again on the edge of the deep, hole here. So you park your kayak over here and you just fish this. Okay, the coordinates are 4 and 2.7, so you guys can see it. And then the last one is here, the Northern Pike. So it's against the reeds. So here I got one, here I got one. Yeah, it's where I throw, but they are sitting everywhere. I use the casting spoon 14G2, so and the 2-0, just the same like the chain pickerel. Okay, try to fish in the day for the pickerels, because and the pike, because they don't bite at night. And the walleye and the sauger is walleye too. It's like the perch family, I think, so at night. Okay, so that's it guys. So you guys see the buoys here, that's the Northern Pike. So that was it. So the guys that want to get started now, you can already start. You got the coordinates, you know where you need to stand. I will show you guys my setup too if you want. So I'm using the Elemental because I like to fish with a rod that is designed for this kind of fish. So no, this is not the right one. I want Elemental. Oh yeah, no, it's a Jigwinger. I'm totally wrong, guys. It's a Jigwinger 270. So it's a very long rod. So you can throw really far with it. So if you are on the shore, it's a little bit more handy that you can throw a little bit further. But in the kayak, it doesn't matter. You guys will see it right away. I'm going with Espira MLR 3000, breadline 0.2, and casting spoon. And you guys, of course, know what you need to use to, because I just showed you. So that was it, the hardcore tutorial. So if you don't want to watch the gameplay, me catching the fish, you can now stop and just go catch the fish by yourself. You will get a lot of fish. So let's get started for the guys that stay for the gameplay. So first of all, I'm going to do a couple of tries on the Northern Pike. The Northern Pike is not that easy because you cannot catch a lot of them. I tried it. I know they are sitting here against the reeds. That's their place. So you guys can see it. I got one over there. That's where I cast it. So it was a little bit closer. I got one at the back. It's totally full here, but they don't bite that well, those fish. So let's put the anchor into the water. So I'm going to forward the time a little bit to, let's say, 12 noon, because that's better. Then I'm going for the champion grill, and then I'm going to forward the time to the night to show you guys the walleye. Okay, so yeah, let's get the rods. Let's do a forward. Ah, I cannot. Yeah, okay. Let's skip this. Let's go to noon. And let's try to get a northern pike. I'm going to do a couple of casts. If it doesn't work, that's how you need to do it, guys. But as already said, it's not easy to get him. So, yeah, you need to try a little bit. But now at the moment, it's very easy to... And now I'm in the deep hole. You guys can see it. So I'm, yeah, on the edge of the deep hole and the shallow water in the reeds. So what I do is, on the two pikes, is I do a lift and drop the whole time. Because in the game... if you go for pike, lift and drop works really well for pike. And that is a bite, I think. Is that a bite? Check. That fish is becoming so active in front. Did you guys see it? I was thinking maybe... Yeah, check. I need to put my drag a little bit higher. Yeah. And if this is a northern pike, I'm going to be very happy. It can be a chain pickerel too. They are sitting over here too. Not a lot of guys know that. I think it's a northern pike, so that's good. So here you go. Northern pike, one-on-one. So that's how easy it is, guys. So keep this fellow. Yeah, that's what you need to do. So I didn't expect that it went this fast. So we can already go for the chain pickerel. Yeah, here we go. And we are gone. So the chain pickerel is on the other side. You guys see over there, the left buoy. Yeah, that's the chain pickerel. But you need to stand behind it. Because the area is totally full with chain pickerel. So, yeah. So that's where I'm going to stand too. This is the walleye mark. This one, so it's very close. So let's turn around. So I like to fish like this. So let's get a little bit in position. A little bit like that. That I can throw always forward to the buoy. So this is good. This is perfect. So we can use the same setup. Casting spoon works really well. You can of course go with the walkers too. The walkers work really well too on this fish. So let's try to get the chain pickerel. Chain pickerel is a very easy fish. You can get a lot of them in the best time of the day. So I'm not expecting a lot of complications to get this fish. There, yeah, that was already a bite. It can be the smaller pickerels too. Yeah, and I want to do a lift and drop too. Lift and drop again. It works really well for the pickerels and the pike here. And you can, yeah, check. This is already a chain pickerel. That's how easy it is. It's not that complicated. Check chain pickerel. Let's get another one. So you can farm really easy. And the good thing about the kayak is you can just park yourself in the sweet spot. If you do it from the shore, you need to throw through those reeds. So that's a little bit more it's not complicated, more complicated, but you don't see shit, you know. It's just throwing blindly. It's not that fun as fishing like this. So I can understand if you come here that you don't have a kayak, but yeah, then you need to stand on the shore. I don't think that you can get a sauger from the shore, if I remember right. Yeah, and now I'm not getting one fish. So you can go all the way until you're on the boat, because they are sitting everywhere here. You see the activity on the lilies over there, but they are sitting everywhere here. So let's do one more cast, and then I'm going to position myself and make my setup for the walleye. Then we go to 9 p.m. Because that's the moment that the night starts, and the walleye is unbelievable. I was the other day fishing here. For a couple of hours in the night, and I had for 4,000 currency on walleye. Every cast I got walleye at night, so they bite really, really well. Yeah, and I think the first one was a lucky one, because it's now the best. Ah, there you go. Lift and drop works so good, it's unbelievable. And this is a trophy, I think. Yeah, a trophy, 1.6. Okay, that's number two. Yeah, let's get the anchor up. Now it's time Ah, okay. Now it's time to position ourselves for the walleye. So what I do is I go a little bit more to the middle of the lake, then I do a U-turn because they are sitting in the holes too. Then we turn just around. I think I'm a little bit too far, yeah. So I want to be a little bit more to the right here. I think this works too. Yeah, come on, kayak dude, don't go too fast. Okay, now we go a little bit backwards. Okay, that's perfect. So let's put the anchor out again. So now I'm going to assemble the setup that I just said to you guys with the shed. The shed works really well. So we need to get a jig head. Let's get rid of the casting spoon. A jig head. This is the good one. You don't need to go that high. And then we are going to put the 7 centimeter, I think it was. Yes, so this is a setup for the walleye at night. And what we are going to do is we are going to go forward again to 9 p.m. and it's going to be night now. So, and that's the best time to get the walleye. So let's get the rod out. Let's throw in the direction of the buoy. So this is the buoy of the walleye. You can do just the same again, stop and go. I don't go with the lift and drop on this one. What works too? A twitching works too. I was really amazed because I always thought that walleye was sitting in the holes, but it seems that twitching works too. So let's try to do a stop and go. And I hope it's a good night because you got, there you go. As I already said to you guys, it's unbelievable the walleye. You can just farm them the whole night long. So that's number one. Let's try to get a second one, and then we already can go to the sauger. That's just behind me on the rock. That's a little bit, harder. But yeah, I said it about the northern pike too, and I got him the first cast. So yeah, sometimes the RNG is very good in this game. Okay, let's try to do a very good stop and go. So a stop and go now is not stopping, but if your lure goes with this nose to the ground, you need to reel again. Yeah, and is this going to be a cast without a walleye? Really? I'm personal nerfed, guys. Personal nerfed. It has to be this. You can go all the way to your boat. Don't hesitate because they are sitting here. I'm now above the hole. So. Yep, he's not going to bite. One more try, and then it's time to go to the last fish for this video. So, if you know where you need to go, guys, it's not that complicated. And if you can read the graphic when the best time is, and when you need to fish for a certain fish, you can catch a lot of fish in this area. At the start, it's not going to be easy because if you, I think, what is it, level 5 or level 7 if you come here, yeah, you need to bite a little bit through that time because it can take some time, but a little bit later you can just farm them the whole day. So that's not a problem. And I think the first one was a lucky one. Check, I'm not getting another one. Normally it's back-to-back walleye. So yeah, I'm very happy that I got that one because normally the walleye was the easiest of the four in my opinion, if you know. But it's now a full moon, I think. Maybe it's not so good. I'm not even sure that the graphic is right. It's possible that later at night the best time is coming. No, it's now. So I'm really amazed that they don't bite better. But now it's time to go to the sauger. That's the last fish of the video. So let's get the anchor back up. It's behind me. It's on the rock over there. So where you need to stand is a little bit to the right. You throw on the edge of the hole, and that's where you're going to get it. You can get the unique too. I think the unique is at night too. You can get the unique champicril too. The other two species, the walleye and the northern pike, only got the trophy version. So for the guys, don't try to get the unique because there is no unique. So it's a pity because in the past there was the unique walleye here. I like that a lot, but they removed it. Don't ask me why, but yeah, sometimes they do things. Why, I don't know. So you park yourself over here, so that you can throw nicely on the edge. So I will show you guys what I mean with it. So here you can see it, so that you can throw here. Check. This is where all the saugers are sitting. But we need to switch now, because we are going now to the night narrow spoon. First I need to get my anchor out again. Then we need to get the setup ready. Let's have a look. It was, I think, the 21G30 that we can use for that fish. It's this one. So let's put it on, because it's night. And let's have a... I'm way too close to the buoy. Okay, let's go backwards. Okay, let's get the rod out. You can do just the same here, like the walleye, a little bit to stop and go. That works really well. Let the lure go to the bottom, and you can see now I'm in the deep part. I'm a little bit to the left, but yeah, that's how you need to do it. I hope that I can get one, because they... Oh yeah, okay. Never mind, guys, never mind. It's my lucky day, I think. So yeah, that's how you need to... And I think this is a really nice one. Here you go, the sauger. So that was it for the video, guys. So I showed you guys all the fish. You guys know the coordinates, you know how you need to get it. It's very handy, the navigation system. So all the big fish in this lake, if you see this video, you can catch them. So I don't need to make any more separate videos. So you guys can just stop the video when I show my navigation system map. And that's it, guys. So thanks for watching, guys. Have fun in New York. I hope that you guys catch as many fish as I just did in the video. And see you later, guys. Bye-bye.